going to be the battle of the sexes episode. Me and Mel versus the birdies.
All right.
So first off the rip, why are girls so crazy? I need to know.
We not crazy.
I'm trying to figure this out my whole life. I'm still not nowhere near the answer. Why?
Y'all make us crazy.
Right.
We make y'all crazy.
Right. Yes.
Do y'all make us crazy?
Probably, but like
that's
not as
true.
Crazy as us.
That's not true.
How do we make y'all crazy?
Yeah.
Cause y'all stupid.
Oh.
It's
do y'all make us stupid?
No, I just feel like y'all can say and do whatever y'all want.
It's women that don't have men that are crazy.
Oh, I'm not speaking for them.
That was a good point though.
Yeah, I'm not speaking for the real life crazy.
And there's men that are crazy too.
Yeah. That wasn't weirdo as things. We just talking about like.
So.
Man, that wasn't weirdo as things. 99.9% of girls are crazy. Y'all talking about like the 0.1% of men who are crazy.
All right, Joe, hold on. I think we need to find clarity. Clarity, like, what type of crazy are you talking about?
We're not talking about snap crazy where like, you know, bitches be chopping you up and trying to kill you and like stalking you. We're just talking about the everyday where they just hear what they want to hear, jump to conclusions.
So these are relationship women. Or these are just women in general.
Because I feel like if you love somebody, you want to like be crazy over.
Women.
Guys too.
Yeah.
Not to the extent or the level or the type that y'all tend to do whatever. Like, I just be so confused.
That's because
you keep saying y'all.
Women express their emotions.
You.
All right,
this is
crazy a little bit.
I'm really not. Y'all just hype it up.
We hear about you in these streets, the police reports.
I feel like women express their emotions a lot more than guys. So it may seem like we're crazy, but we're just expressing ourselves. Mm. You guys don't express yourselves.
We don't express ourselves.
Not as much, no.
So you don't think it's that we don't feel as much? Not that we're not. Expressing ourselves.
Yes.
But now should the question be, maybe y'all shouldn't be feeling so much. Maybe y'all need to calm down.
I mean, as women, we are like emotional, but for men, like, it could be the littlest stuff and it'd be like, I gotta let him know beforehand.
See, the thing that get me is, this is what makes y'all crazy.
Okay.
Matter of fact, let's take, this is what makes y'all insane.
All right, go there.
Because a woman,
girl,
look, she got, a woman to ask a man to do something. As far as like she just said, like, you know, a woman is, they'll go and say, oh yeah, you know, I'm gonna hop on the little things before they turn big. So then as a man, we think a little bit more logical, we let a little bit more stuff go, and then we'll build it up and stuff might get big, and then y'all say, well, you should have told me this back when it was level one, it's on level 10 now. Exactly. But then we start telling y'all level one every time, and then you say, nigga, you crazy.
But that's what y'all saying about us. Y'all don't do that. If y'all pinpoint y'all problems in the beginning, it wouldn't be like we crazy.
Daysha, make sure you speak into the mic, whatever.
Oh.
I'm sure you said that. Don't let you know.
I talk a little,
don't be scared of the mic.
I feel like as women, we do care about the little things more than the men do. And those little
AKA
things,
the petty things.
It's not always
petty. They really aren't that important in the grand scheme of life.
Not important to you.
And life. And that's what y'all always put it. Just because it's not important to you.
Exactly.
Yo, the shit do not be important. Like
it
doesn't matter 2 weeks later, so is it important?
And that's, if it's important to me, whenever time it is, it's important.
Okay, so that's like,
I feel like we should talk about it.
It goes
back. You know who used that logic? Niggas who be killing niggas over petty shit. Nigga stepped on my foot. Nigga, I had fresh new sneakers on, so nigga had to go. That was important to me. No, it's not important, because you're going to get new sneakers, then that nigga dead.
Don't step on my sneakers, though.
Okay, so you might got some crazy in them.
Exactly.
But, and y'all, you want to say something, though? You want to make a point?
No, it's just, at the end of the day, everything that we going to talk about with craziness just comes back to emotion versus logic.
And I feel like men, y'all admit to y'all faults. But then when we bring it to y'all attention about the faults that y'all say on a daily basis, y'all be like, oh, so you're calling me crazy now, or you're judging me, whatever. But we can admit, like, niggas know, like, we horny or dick hard, our IQ drops. We not of ourselves. And we fight through that, whatever. But y'all don't give y'allself the same, like, responsibility. Like, y'all, I know I'm crazy. You shouldn't give me my feelings, though, because that's what's going to happen. I'm going to act crazy. But no, why? Once you get there, you should be like, I'm going to fight through this. You know, I'm going to get some therapy.
I want to admit.
You know, I'm going to breathe.
I'm that type of way, like, Like, I feel like if I feel like I'm acting crazy, or not even say acting crazy, if I'm like feel strongly about something, mm-hmm. I like to sit on it for a little while. Mm-hmm. Either it'll blow me up even more mad, or I'll calm down.
Then I blow up on it.
I was say, that's crazy. You gonna kill somebody.
So if I calm
like
down,
I sit on it. And then...
If I calm down, I usually just let it go. But
okay, give me a percentage. How often do you let it go?
I let it go at least.
And Daysha, confirm or deny when she says
60% of the time.
Is that true, Daysha?
70. I'll say 70. Yeah.
So 30, she lets it go the same percent of the time?
Yeah, she's way better than me.
Okay.
So 30% of the time you plot premeditated murder.
I can take that. I think most girls are the other way around. They don't let it go the same percent of the time.
So you cool with premeditated murder?
Well, they are. They all do that. They all think about killing at least once every now and then. Probably. You put me there. I just love you that much. That's how much I care about you. I just want you to be. Who's more prideful, men or women?
Men.
Mel. I'm just turning my back on them.
You can say it. It's men.
No, I'm trying to be reasonable. I'm trying to be real, real reasonable.
It ain't no way in hell men are more prideful than women. It's no what? Way.
Yes,
I don't think we are.
How?
What do you mean how?
How?
For one, y'all don't express your emotions.
How that mean we prideful?
Yeah, that don't mean you not.
What?
Just think about it. It's the actual saying where they be like, happy wife, happy life. That's a saying. So? We gotta deal with y'all bullshit. We gotta be like, we gotta be the
but
bigger
it's not
man.
Like
we're
not dealing with
we gotta.
Bullshit either.
What do y'all do? That y'all don't, that,
I don't want to put you out there, so like.
Put who out there?
First of all, she was your government. She said,
"Right, that's how you know."
Who out there?
I take it there.
Tank top.
Okay.
Who you putting who out there?
Like you're like crazy too. I don't understand why you don't think you're crazy.
No.
Like your Snapchats is
cute.
Like,
isn't crazy.
Look, let's talk about it. Oh, let's talk about it. Let's take a drink. Everything is shut out. We gonna talk about this because putting me out there. For you, sir. Y'all keep talking. What are these accusations?
I feel like.
What is that concoction you got there?
It's a mix.
Is it? I thought it was just cranberry juice.
No, it's like the crown's up there.
We had it. It just tastes like cranberry juice.
What? Oh, you want to take a shot? What y'all take for a shot?
Like, you try to pull some slick shit.
Right.
Anyway. Continue with these accusations.
So, what? This was the pride thing? I'm talking about the pride.
No. Bates? Turned it on me and said I'm crazy and some shit.
I feel like men don't like to apologize.
Oh yeah,
yo, you know what?
They have to apologize.
It takes time though. I'm gonna keep it a bean. We like.
But I feel like if y'all find out like that you're wrong,
we gotta let it register sometimes.
Y'all gonna say it to us. You'll probably say it to your friend and be like, "No, I was wrong." But I ain't gonna tell her I was.
That's
wrong.
That's a certain type of dude. Because at the same time, yo, at first I can keep it all the way of bean. At first I would be like, "Yo, I ain't wrong." Even if I would have knew I was wrong, but. Over time, no, some real shit. Like, over time, it takes time for you to. I'd rather say I'm wrong than us beef over it for days. But what happens is, once you do say you're wrong, then what a woman could possibly do is be like, "You said you was wrong, so I'm gonna carry this out for 3 months. Your wrongness. I don't want to be wrong for 3 months." So a lot of guys can't be wrong for three.
I feel
three
like
months.
I get an apology is like, okay.
Lying.
I don't care about apologies, you know? I just want to know that you understand where I'm coming from. Like, a lot of times
changed.
Guys is like, you're acting crazy for no reason. I'm not acting crazy for no reason. There's a reason why I'm...
Yeah, it is a reason. It's just a dumb reason.
No!
Or it's a petty reason. I don't respect pettiness.
Why is it
happening? Alright, Q, describe your petty so yeah, the world can know your definition of a petty reason.
Okay, let me think of a petty example.
A real petty reason, like something that can happen every day.
Quick, my kid. Something petty that a girl would do.
Like a petty mad reason. Like, what do you like? What?
I can only think of some like trivial shit I see on Twitter. Like, where they be like, "Oh, he texted me back a couple hours later. Now I'm gonna have an attitude. Why?"
That's me.
Why? It's not that deep.
Like,
who cares?
If you're not doing nothing, I can say if you're at work, okay, you're at work. But if you're not doing nothing, you on Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram. You're not going to text me back 3 hours later and think that it's okay.
Who cares?
Also, people forget.
Yeah, who cares?
No. If your phone is in your hand 24 hours.
He forgot. He probably forgot to press send. He probably looked at the, oh,
you didn't forget to press send when you go on Twitter. Snapchat, all
how do y'all think? Hey, yo, the dots they connect, yo, like the correlations. What did I gotta do me forgetting to press send? Or be like, oh, I just, it slipped my mind.
You didn't forget to press send. You looked at it and was like, oh, I'm gonna talk to her later.
All right, look.
That doesn't happen as often as you think, but.
Niggas be fried.
Okay.
And drunk. And 2K'd out.
Alright.
Maybe y'all
need to get our
lives
together.
Wait, we got our lives together. It's 2K. We got our lives together.
My career is booming. My player averaged a triple double.
Talk about it.
Alright.
Oh, shit. Wait, did you take your first one?
Come on, man.
I don't want to disrespect myself.
When I had my phone, I forget to press send. I'll be like, why ain't you texting back yet? But and then I realized I forgot to press send. So I'm thinking in my head that, like, I'm thinking of him.
And we never care.
Exactly, and that's the problem. Because
it's not that deep.
It is.
Yo, I'm going to tell you the way men, our mind is, right? The average man is like, yo, if I did not fuck nobody else in this moment, or did not do that until, like, outwardly disrespect you, blatantly disrespect you, you should have no reason to be seriously mad at me.
What?
That's how we think. If it ain't on the those lines, I didn't do nothing. It ain't that deep. Because the way we look at it is, we not going to be mad at you unless you really did something along those lines.
So if I text you back 3 hours later, say like,
I do not give a fuck. Like,
no, I'm not going to text you 3 hours later. I'm going to text you like 5 hours later.
You can text me 2 days later. Say like, no. No, but like, no,
petty
seriously.
Wait, no, Q.
Petty goals.
Wait, Q, if your girl texts you 3 hours later, you ain't going to be here.
Especially if you know she went out with her girls.
I'm not going
to. Come out and be upset. Like, why you ain't texting me back?
No.
I really don't care.
I prefer.
River Deck, reggae nights.
You're at a party, right?
I'm about to say I like when my girl go out with her girls, like, that's your girl time. I don't want her to feel like she's obligated. I get upset at some stuff, like some stuff that you do with them. You know, like, but a text is not that serious. As long as I know that you're safe,
if you don't get a text the whole night, you won't be mad.
I mean, she gonna come home at the end of the night. And,
like, yo, that's what really matters. Like, did I contact you at all?
I mean, you gotta let me know you're gonna stay at your girl's
house.
Her phone
died
or something.
Oh my god.
Your phone got charged.
What if she did? Forgot to press
here,
send.
Here go girl. Here go the girl logic.
Yeah,
what
like, this is not
what
logic. This is not a woman logic. This is.
Damn, what if she got hit by a car and then tell you?
This is. Damn,
what if a dick fell in her mouth?
That's how
y'all. Damn, he right. I just gotta counter everything he said.
Right. I just gotta counter it no matter what. Yeah. Like.
What goes through a girl's head is like, it's like a bunch of things. Like, we.
Everything. Y'all invent everything in your mind.
Like, yeah, it's just like.
This is CSI. This is.
Is he safe? Is he with another girl? Like,
that, see, the second reason, you don't care about my safety.
Exactly. They want to put that out there first.
That's the first thing.
Is he alive?
That's the first thing.
Who the bitch?
And then it's like 2 hours later, it's like, oh, he's safe. He just want to play. Okay. That's where it goes.
Or, okay, how about this? Some people are like that. I know I'm very lax about things.
You're very lax.
Right. So if you care about not getting responses in a timely fashion, all right, cool. But once I text you back, it should be over. That's how I feel. Y'all have problems with once you get past the irritation stage or the irk stage, whatever it is, just moving past it. Then y'all want to hold on to, like, no, now I got an attitude. Now you got to make it up. No, you were mad about it. Like, I gave you an explanation of what happened or why you were mad at it.
If you explain what happened, it's like, okay. And, like, I would say, I don't like that. Mm-hmm. Like, if I know you're not doing nothing, then it's like, don't text me every hour. Just say you busy, so that way I know. Like,
I forgot.
Okay, you can say you forgot the first time, but if it's like 5,000 times,
I forgot again.
Then not 5,000 times.
Right.
I forgot. I'm busy.
Like,
I forgot.
Like, she don't like that.
Huh?
That should come up like, oh, she don't like that. So like,
is it that deep?
Yes.
I feel like it is.
Why?
If something is important to somebody, you want to...
That doesn't make it... That doesn't even...
Listen, it should be, though.
Why?
If something is important to Daysha, mm-hmm. I'm going to make sure that I'm going to do the best that I can that she doesn't feel some type of way of what I'm doing.
Right.
So, if I know that she likes to know, like, to hear from me, like, once every 5 hours, mm-hmm. I'm going to text her at least every 5 hours.
Okay, I look at it this way. Out of all my friends, I'm the most active reacher out or whatever, how you want to phrase it. Whatever. I'm the one who bring it right together. I'm the one who texts people for birthday, shut that, whatever. I'm not going to be mad at somebody not text me, like, if they're not like that. That's not how they are. Because, like, it doesn't matter. Like, or if somebody don't text me for my birthday, I might be like, dang, he texted my birthday. I move past it because it's not that deep. Like, it doesn't matter. I know they're still my friend.
What? I feel like my close friends will be like right there.
If nobody else texts me my birthday, I'm not texting.
Can you text me? This is why I know he's not lying. I got it right here on my phone. Q texted me on Friday at 4:16 p.m. and said, "Yo, bro, are you still free for Monday?" I didn't text back. I think I was probably playing 2K.
That's but guys. If my girl texts me, it's like, that's I gotta
guys.
Go.
That's guys.
That's
guys.
Logical.
Like, sure
that's
okay.
Life.
I gotta call her mom and be like, "Where Alexa's at?" Because I don't know where she is.
He know I'm alive.
So
he probably
text me back.
He probably was playing the cake too.
That's okay. I always consider myself, I'm sensitive. I'm like emotional.
She messed up. She said y'all get into a lot of stuff, but when y'all texting us, we don't get into nothing.
No,
we just supposed to be free.
Yes.
I mean, if y'all like at work or something, or like playing ball,
preach.
Cool.
Preach.
I already know what they doing.
I ain't playing ball. My ACL messed up. He know I was in.
I ain't talking to you, but
you know I was in.
Like, okay.
You know I'm
about to go hang out with these guys. All right, I already know what he doing. I ain't worried about that. But if you're not doing nothing, then.
You know, I could have been watching TV mind my business, but hey, it was a good
part
of the show.
If you're watching TV, your phone is in your hand.
Yes, right. Yo, what happens? This is what happened with the new iPhone, right? The new update. So I be on my phone, right?
And then
I pull the message down from the notification, and I'm like, okay, I'm gonna respond back to it whenever I'm doing something else, or whatever. And I forget about it, and then because you know once you pull it down, the alert doesn't be there anymore.
See,
so you forget.
See, I do the same thing, but about people I don't care about. If I don't care about you.
You know people gonna see this, right?
I don't care.
I don't care about you.
Exactly. Like, if I don't care about you, I forgot that you text me. I'll open up or I look that you text me and I won't open it, but I'll see in my notifications.
See, we're not that literal. We just do it because that's
smart.
Oh, because we're not smart. Because it's not that deep. That's why I say all the time dealing with the female, you know, dealing with the missus. It's just not that deep. I didn't forget about what y'all said. Y'all, I'm crazy.
Oh, yeah, you crazy.
Yeah, I'm still waiting to see what y'all talking about. Like,
I didn't say you're crazy.
My Snapchats or whatever.
I said that you don't care. I say that, like, stuff that should bother you or, like, you should. No, if your girl is feeling some type of way about something, I feel like it's just, like, she acting crazy. She better get over it.
But, you know,
I know my opinion.
For the record, the few times I've told you about some experiences or some stories, 9 times out of 10, you agree with me. So, what does that really mean? Yeah, she agrees with me, Daisy. So, you talking about I don't be caring, I don't be doing, but you be agreeing with me, so.
I feel like when you.
Up top.
One for
like,
when she
one for men.
Because she was like, I'm always waiting for her. I mean, we're a girl, we gotta get dressed, we gotta get cute. Like,
no,
and I feel like y'all don't appreciate that.
This is the problem. I'm sure you probably maybe experiences, whatever. You say, I'm like, all right, I'm like, what time you gonna be ready? You tell me 7:30. I'm like, you sure? And you're like, yes, I'll be ready at 7:30. It's noon. It's noon right now. It's noon.
You
say you'll be at 7:30. I get there at 7:30, 7.5 hours later, and you be like, okay, I'm gonna be an hour late.
Things come
break
up.
Break this. How? That means you're insensitive. That means you don't respect my time because you already told me 7 hours ago you're gonna be ready at 7:30.
I feel like it's not my feelings, so I can't say nothing. But like. I'm just taking up for my ladies.
So I should brought up a random ass topic when
I
made a good point. So I made a good point. What do I gotta do with you being late and lying about time?
That's what you wanna know what I gotta do with? Emotion versus logic.
Don't you want me to look my best for you?
That's the name of this episode.
7 hours?
That's the name of this episode.
Seven hours?
It depends on where we're going.
You ever seen a girl get dressed? Watching a girl get dressed is probably one of the most mind numbing things in the world.
No. That's number two.
What's number one?
Going shopping.
Ooh, my nigga.
For me being a girl, ooh. I hate shopping unless I'm by myself.
I love my girl to death.
You know what I hate?
Shopping is.
No, I like what now we respect my mom is, you know, she's a woman. Actually, no, my mom's not a typical girl because she'd be in and out, whatever. But even then, she never dragged.
Shout out to
me.
She made me take like 2 shots before we left.
Shots!
Shot.
But she never dragged my stepdad to the mall. Cause she knows he don't give a fuck about it, and he doesn't want
to
be there.
That's how
women,
I feel. I would
y'all,
not take nobody with me.
Yeah,
I hate shopping.
I don't like to
shop
with people.
Shout out to y'all. But a lot of women like dragging, like they literally drag their men to the mall, and they know he don't want to be there. They know he's miserable. But I want to be with you though.
I want to do it because I hate people complaining.
Also, women are more selfish than men in relationships. Facts.
Okay.
I'm glad we agree on one thing.
I agree. We're selfish. I agree.
Evil laugh and shit. Moving on. What do y'all think about the 90-day rule as women? Some women do it. What do y'all think about it? Think it's realistic?
You mean like before sex?
Mm-hmm.
It's 2016.
2016.
This generation probably don't know nothing about it.
I mean, I feel like this generation now is just like,
they don't know nothing about it.
You do whatever and,
like, if you got some wild,
married in like the 90s.
You got a bottle of this Crown Royal Apple, it's 2016.
I really hate him.
That's what's. It's not our generation. We probably beat it. It's probably some respectable women out there. And I shout them out.
I mean, I feel like some guys will wait the 90 days, and then like after the 90 days, they hit it and then be like asshole. So it's like,
why does it have to be 90 days?
Yeah.
Well, that's just.
Nah, I think 90 days is just like a classic thing. I think just kind of like if you can hold off past the first, second, and third date.
I think it's really just unrealistic, even if it's like 10 days.
Second and third day is 90 days.
I'm saying like,
no. If you stop in the flow, even if it's after one day, I feel it's just selfish. And we vibe and we connect.
Exactly, that's what I'm trying to say.
It could be 4 hours.
You know that you.
It's 2016.
I don't know about that.
I'm just saying, we're really connected on that level.
No.
I'm just saying, like, you know me. Like,
our generation beat the curve on a lot of stuff, though.
Because we grew extreme.
Yeah, it's like, now, for real, like, if you 20 and below, they don't even know what 90, like, when they gonna hear, if they hear this, they don't know what 90 day rule is.
Cool, wait, 90 days, that's a lot.
And then the older generation is like, oh, we live by it, knowing damn well y'all 90s women was out there, y'all invented twerking, first of all.
Talk about it.
Our generation beat it where
from
it was
the
like,
99 and 2000s, look up in the
clap us.
Talk about it.
That shit, man.
Shots.
But, I feel as though our generation was probably the best with it because it was right in the middle. You had the respectables and you had the women that, I mean, I don't even say they're not respectable women. Mm-hmm. It was just they follow the emotion more than the logic.
Sorry, no, shout out to Mel for breaking the sobriety.
No, I didn't break the sobriety.
Breaking the sobriety.
Did.
I mean,
he did.
It's a celebration of RightonQuelive podcast. Look, you break sobriety.
And
if
our hair is safe, I was going to drink again, but.
Oh, no. You know what? My ACL, look, I tore my ACL, being a real nigga.
He ain't had no painkillers, so, you know, he needs a little liquor to break the edge. You know, shout out to him. Continue with your point.
I want to give a shout out to Alcoholics Anonymous. I see my group later.
We all
will. Life is a journey.
But I feel like if you know what you want, when you want it, I feel like you should do what you want to do, when you want to do it, how you want to do it. And I feel like there should be no standard on when you should do it. Like, if you feel that that's what you want, that's what you want.
Respectable.
Definitely.
Why wait and or not wait if, like...
It's a classical standard. That was a classical thing. That was for the common church-going, respectable woman. That was like... there's no real comparison, but back in the day, that was like the thing. Like, you know, you have to be classy. That was the standard of classy. That was like, oh, you have to do the 90 days, see if he really likes you. A guy can really like you, but, you know, like 90 days, show me you like me. What are you doing to like me?
Talk about it. Right. And I mean, it just continues with the whole narrative of, like, women overthinking and thinking too much as well. Like, oh, but we're great together. He's a great guy. We like each other, but, you know... 90 days. I'm just waiting 90 days. There's fucking overthinking.
And not even with the bad generation, like, at all. You know, I've been out the game a long time. Mm-hmm. Shout out. We made 5 years the other day. Been out the game a long time, but fucking
goals.
Goals.
We always got work
to do. Instagram goals.
We always got work to do.
Relationship goals.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate that. But people look at it, and it's like, you know, 90 days, that's a long-ass time for some people. And a guy can take you out to fucking Del Frisco's. He can take you out to any seafood house you want to go to. He can take you out, spend all these racks. Mm-hmm. He ain't got no racks to spend. As being a gentleman, like, a guy start taking you out, like, on the beginning, no, you know, you ain't really, he don't really want you to break the bank. If you do offer, oh, I'm going to go half, or I'm going to, that's cool and everything, but when the shit first start rolling, if y'all mutual and y'all both got it, he's going to try to be the one to provide.
How often do y'all pay for outings with men? Like, if you with a guy, like, seriously, y'all talking or whatever, how often would you pay?
If we talking or we're in a relationship?
See? 90
if
days.
We're in a relationship.
Relationship.
They like, not going to pay for
it. It'd be like
days.
The little cheap stuff. It'd be like, oh, okay, I'll let her pay for it.
I'm talking about you, just willing to pay. Even if he stop you, just you will reach for your money, shit like that.
I feel like if he has been paying for the last couple of times we've been out, it's like, oh, okay, I got it. Like, I'm not that type of one that'd be like, oh, no, niggas can't, no, I ain't going out unless he pay for it.
Kelly's
like,
one of those girls. Her face is like,
but that's still my best friend.
I haven't paid for 1 meal in life.
Like, I don't mind.
I pay for, like, Chick-fil-A or something like that.
Bruh.
The like, stuff, though.
Not even for a birthday?
For the birthday, I feel like if it's his birthday, we balling out.
So you had like maybe 30% you were paying?
Yeah.
And you're at like 10.
Yeah. But look, my mama always told me like,
don't pay for shit, girl.
My mom and my stepdad have been together for like since I was like in first grade, mm-hmm. and she's never paid for anything. So right. she's always told me like, you shouldn't need to. So like, I know if we're like in the same situation and we both graduated from college and we're both trying to find ourselves, like I'll chip in or you pay for the meal, I'll tip or something like that. But like, if it's something small like a Chick-fil-A or McDonald's drive-thru, mm-hmm. but like if we're at Del Frisco's, I'm not paying for anything.
Yeah, I'm not paying for the Frisco's.
Damn. Like, little stuff. I feel
lucky.
I definitely always pay. Like, I definitely always have that mindset where I should pay more than not. So exactly. I'm cool with that, whatever. Be. But I will, that's not one of my standards where I feel like a woman should be willing to pay off. Yeah. But I do appreciate it. It's like a bonus type thing. Whatever.
Exactly.
But like, I do think like, it's like a nice bonus if it's kind of off.
I usually do the tip instead.
30% is good to me. 30%, a girl paying 30% of the time, that really ain't shit. But
if you pay for dinner, I would usually do like the tip.
That's cool. Even that's what a lot of girls don't know.
Pay
like,
for dinner, men, I'll pay for the movies.
That's cool. That's great.
Not the
women don't know that men care about the. We care about the most simplest shit. Like, girl, be like, yo, like, I got the tip. Or like, yeah, you know, he paid 10 times in a row, and you pay that 11th time. Oh shit! Or you like, he pump his gas, so here go like an extra 10. What? Like little shit. Like, we don't need that much. Like,
ain't chipping in on gas.
But I'm not saying you have to, but just like little shit, like he could have spent $1,000 on you that week, but you gave him $10 for gas. Like, oh shit, good luck. Like it ain't. What, $10?
I would hope that you wouldn't accept that from me. Like,
really? With the $10?
Yeah.
That he would turn it down?
Yeah, like. You know how you.
I feel like he wasn't going to use it. Like, he'll probably just put it
okay,
up.
Okay, okay. What do you think about that, Mel? Talk to me. What do you think about that? She said if she offers something, she would expect you to turn it down.
Don't offer it.
Right.
First of all, don't
why offer I play it. The mind games?
I mean,
he just spent $1,000 on you in that week. Are you going to bitch about
$10? That's different.
How is it different? You said you were expecting to turn it down.
We just so happen to be very fortunate. Me, I would say me in particular, because mm-hmm. you really find out a lot about a woman, mm-hmm. how much they care, a whole bunch of stuff. Real rap. You really find out because... She sat over there. She said, "Shit, I hope you turn it down." Like,
first of all, if you can spend $1,000 on me, you can spend an extra 10 with that gas.
It's not the point though. The point is that you offered it. He's like, "Yo, good luck." I'm just putting this in my pocket for like chips later on or something.
That's what I gotta clarify. You can put it in the little card thing.
Yeah, he ain't gonna use that for the gas.
No, this what I gotta clarify. Is this like your man or is this just like a
talk? No, we said it's your man.
Oh, this is your man. Then I'll chip with anything. I'll chip with
that. First, believe I, like I know you ain't giving no nigga you was talking to money anyway, so why are you even throwing date tracking? Like,
when you dating and then fix your man is really different.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was about to say, y'all is this like. Birds, is this, yeah, that's what I got lost on. I don't know if it's this just like somebody you talking to or is this like your man.
Well, with me, I know. Actually, with me, if I'm talking to a girl. Okay, one difference. The difference between me and talking to a girl and cuffing a girl is just what I'm going to deal with. Like, the mouth. And headaches and all that shit, that's only gonna be taken from a girlfriend. But as far as what I'm willing to do for a girl, I do anything for a girl if I'm talking to her because I like you to some degree where I'm even talking to you for a period of time. So even like money wise, that's you know, I realize the girls are different that way to like if that nigga ain't your man, y'all don't have no picks.
Exactly.
Like,
mm-hmm. If we're not in a relationship, I honestly feel like I shouldn't pay for anything.
I ain't gotta spend.
Interesting. Money. I've actually been in, you know, situationships or like talking stages with girls. Where it false. Where they actually, you know, girls pay for certain things, whatever, you know.
Mm-mm.
Do you buy talking so guys things like gifts or whatever? Like no. If his birthday come up?
No.
Yeah, I will buy.
Wait, even if that was your man, you don't
no, if that was my man, just talking, yeah, I'm talking.
You wanna buy a girl now? Y'all just talking for her birthday?
No.
I'll send you a text.
I'm a bugger. I had bugger stuff. They were just their birthday. It's their birthday.
I feel like you're on stage.
I ain't spending racks.
You're kind of performing. Like
I'm dead serious. I'm not.
No. I'm saying like, as a guy, if you're just talking, like,
yeah, that's our condition.
Like man. Talking. You gotta put a time limit. Like, we talking like a month, 2 months,
a couple months.
Buying you a drink.
Like
huh?
Past 2 months.
He said, "I'm not buying you a drink."
Past 3 months.
Know yourself. Know your worth.
Right.
Past 3 months. You ain't good enough for talking. Birthday. Y'all talking. Past 3 months. You ain't good enough for birthday.
I feel like like past 3 months. Like if y'all all together.
Come on.
Then at least you could buy her drinks.
Mate, yeah.
A birthday.
You said at least buy drinks. Birthday.
Like at least you could buy his drinks. Like if y'all talking.
Yeah, that's
y'all
cool. Who? How many drinks? It's his birthday. He's trying to turn up. No, I mean, you buy him like two drinks.
A girl should never buy a guy a drink.
It's his fucking birthday. Like, I mean, what?
Let's clarify. Let's make sure everybody. We gotta keep clarifying this. This is only talking.
For the talking thing, I feel like. Yo. I mean, for my friend's birthday, so it's always like, oh, go get you a drink, but don't go too far.
No, for your birthday, yeah, I'm not buying you.
Don't get that Don Louie of 1942. Don't get that Louie. Don't get that young.
I come back tomorrow.
So the guy you've been talking to for 6 months, you're not going to buy him a drink for his birthday?
No, I'll buy you a gift for your birthday, but I feel like buying a drink is something the guys are supposed to do. Like, I feel like you're supposed to buy me a drink.
But you want to know what's messed up about that?
What?
Because in today's generation, you feel like a guy is supposed to do stuff. Guys, they look at women. I have a lot of single guy friends. They look at women like if they buy you a drink, a woman is supposed to do stuff too.
No.
And you don't agree with that, right?
I don't agree.
And just how you don't agree with that, a lot of guys won't agree with they should be buying their drinks.
I have the theory of like the more olden times where like the guy's provider.
She in the 1960s.
Where the guy is the provider. So
see, that worked out back then when guys.
So you telling me you doing everything your grandma doing, huh?
Kinda.
So you shutting up.
What do you mean I'm shutting up?
Know your place, get in that kitchen, and shut up.
My grandma didn't take all that.
Yeah, she did. Maybe when she got older, she got a little bit, you know, a little wilder with it.
That's the older time. So it's like, nowadays, with how things have caught up, where it's not just like crazy, first of all, crazy, extreme, Afrocentric, feminist, they better not come at me with that. Because a woman can be so extreme, but at the same time, this is 2016, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If a woman wants to be treated equal, you know, me and my girl, we don't say 50-50. We say 100-100.
Mm-hmm. Talk about it.
Because I'm messed up right now. Torn ACL, everything.
That's different.
It's not different.
It's disabled. So
I'm handicapable is what I like to call it.
Disabled.
That's a slur. Don't say.
Yeah, right. Shout out to all my niggas in wheelchairs, crutches, all that, holding down.
Mm-hmm. So there's like some things that you can't do, but like, in that case, you have your wife or your girlfriend or whatever to pick up your slack.
Say wife.
Mm-hmm. In that case. But I feel like if we're both healthy and we're both fine.
So if we both healthy, both fine, both making, let's just say, 50, 60 racks a year, he's still just supposed to pick up every tag.
I wouldn't say everything. All right, say everything. In a household.
Sure,
it
says she had 20%.
You said 20, he's supposed to pick up 80% of the.
I
feel like he should be the main provider. Like, he should pay the mortgage or the rent, and I'll pay, like,
you know what women do when they do that?
Like,
they be stacking up, waiting for you to fuck up and just bounce on your head. They done got, like, 100 racks stacked up. Like,
I'll pay the mortgage.
They ain't pay a bill ever. They got all his bread stacked up. Like,
right. They want to have a joint bank account. You got the Puerto Rico bank account.
They be taking shit out. Like, he ain't going to know this. Men are stupid, right? Yeah, just withdrawing everything.
But anyway.
Then get all the bread on the divorce.
Talk about it.
I already got 40 racks.
I feel like that.
We carry the baby house stuff.
If I hear one more woman say pull the baby card, yo. Why y'all telling us? Tell God that. Why y'all putting that on us? Like,
why would y'all look like that?
First of all,
he almost fell out of his shirt. Yes.
What did Eve persuade Adam to do?
But Mel's face is hard.
She ruined everything.
But Adam didn't have to deal with it.
Don't put that peach in my face.
Mm-hmm.
But Adam didn't have to deal with it.
Your punishment was carrying that. We're not going to get religious.
He getting deep with it.
We're not going to get religious.
Go there, Mel.
Adam didn't have the willpower and the balls.
We already said. We are just as.
We can admit our faults.
Naive.
But you have to admit
I'm
going to
say
faults.
Dumb. When we are horny as when y'all are emotional. So, put that peach in my face. Poor Adam couldn't control himself. Couldn't control himself. But that's the first woman ever seen in his life.
Who got
what
punished?
What is this?
Who got punished? The woman got punished in that. Because, but we, you know, this is not, we not going to dive into religious things. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
we
should stay away from that.
But, that's how it is, you know.
What do y'all think about, I see this meme went around a lot recently on Twitter about man moans. Doom.
Shout out Yes Jules.
Oh, you smart.
You loyal.
You are loyal. Do mammals turn y'all off? Men moaning during sex.
No.
Well, okay, what depends on what?
Like the little, like, the actual moans. Mm-hmm. But, like, if you're talking that, like,
Talk that talk.
Yeah, and this.
What do y'all say during sex?
Don't talk that talk if you trash.
I mean, I'm hitting, so I'm not trash.
But it's like
that's what niggas think.
I'm saying, women, we
niggas
not
don't
gonna
think
say
they
nothing.
Trash when they end it.
We're not gonna say nothing if y'all trash. Mm. Like,
talked about this before,
I feel like you do.
She likes more talking during sex, and I don't. Mm. But it depends on
you're
the type.
Such a bird.
It
just
sometimes.
It depends on, like, the type of talking. Like, I don't like a lot of conversation. Like,
yeah, don't talk
if you doing what you doing, like, you're going to hear it through my moans. Mm-hmm. Like, and then if I'm doing what I'm doing by giving you oral, then you're going to know, I'm going to feel it through your moans. Like, there's no need for all this conversation.
So you like, wild talking?
I don't like wild talk. It got to be, like, I can't even explain it. But, like, don't do too much.
Can a man call you a bitch?
No, you can't call me a bitch.
Okay, I heard something, girl.
That's when I'm ready to get up. Like,
okay, cool.
No.
Y'all say daddy?
No.
I can't say daddy.
That's so gross.
Hey, I'm actually with y'all. Like, you know, I don't like a lot of talking. That's whereas, like, the girl.
You said, can they used to call you a bitch?
Yo, it's 2016. You said it, yo.
We can't keep using 2016.
Yo, it's 2016. Like, but I've heard girls where they just be talking so much, like, oh, like, bitch, shut up. Like, I'm more for moan. Like, moan forever. But the talking, I like talking shit sometimes.
It's not for the guys
to
moan.
I talk a little heavy sometimes, whatever, but not too much, you know, in spaces. Yeah.
I would say, given oral, I like the moans because I know, like, I feel like I'm accomplished. Like, I'm doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
And it makes me be like, okay, I
did it right. Mel, you ever been humbled during sex or any kind of sex?
Ever done what?
Humbled.
Humbled how?
Humble. I feel like some guys need to be humbled.
A lot of guys need to be humbled.
Like, explain, I need you. Like,
they should deal with that too. She likes to humble people.
I really do.
Okay. Before I get back to it, what do you mean? What do you mean?
I feel like, and I'm horrible.
Oh, damn, you cool.
I had a couple of drinks because usually, like, I'm quiet.
Take one more. I'm okay.
But, like, some guys are just like, oh, he not even gonna listen to it. Okay. Anybody talk about you? Shut up.
No,
it was this guy, like, we just started talking again. And he was like, when you gonna come bust it open for a real nigga? And
talking about a nigga say that?
That's the first time I heard it since younger.
Wait, when was this?
We're not gonna say when it was, but
he said,
like,
you gonna come bust it open
for a real nigga.
You know how, like, it was a joke, but in my mind it was just like,
but he said it.
In 5 seconds, I'm going to humble you because it's not even that good, so.
Oh, so you already hit, though?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Like, we used to talk back in the day.
Hey, fortune favors the bold. Like, yeah.
But if it's, like, the worst, then it's like, excuse me.
I'm still real, though.
Let me tell you about yourself for a second, so you can come back this way.
I'm just not a porn star. I'm a real nigga.
He said, I'm just not a porn star.
I'm a real nigga.
I wouldn't even say it.
He said, bust it open for a real nigga.
I'm real. That's what Bull. Shout out to Bull.
Shout out to Bull.
I respect
that. That would have been my cue to lead.
He's a little
bit. But so you never been humbled like that, though, where, like, girl, like, yo, you're really not that good, like, or you need to work this.
I feel like the girl should humble you in the beginning.
I've been humbled with Ian Pussy before. I've been humbled. I thought I was putting work on this girl or whatever. And we was talking in conversation about it after the fact. And she was like, you're not that good. I thought she was playing. Then I found she wasn't playing.
That's good, though,
because
you could learn from
it. Right. And I went back to the drawing board, sharpened up my skills. And, you know, change your life after that. Because she changed my life. So
see,
shout out to her. But I got humbled.
That's what
you're
supposed to do.
And I had to take that.
I'm going to
keep it on the chin.
You're not supposed to get upset. You're supposed to go learn from your mistakes and build though, right?
That's all life is about, man. Life is about progression.
If you don't, that's when I have to humble you again, and then all about.
See, one, then once you get humble one or one, then you might got off yourself, because you can niggas want to take so many shots.
I'm confused
to the fry.
Though. I don't understand how you humble somebody and then you go back after you had to humble them, because obviously something had you coming back. But we gonna get back to that.
Oh, why not? Well, it's humbled as in like it wasn't great, but it was good type shit. Oh,
all right,
that type shit.
That.
Yeah, not that it was fucking nigga. You
or if you really like the person, but the sex wasn't that great. I can dig that. Like you can, they can get better, but you really like the
you
person.
Put the time in for the person.
Exactly.
Yeah, I can dig that. Me personally, though.
You a pastor, right? You never got humble.
No. I'm not. I don't know my abilities. I can only go by what
the reviews.
I mean, you know.
Your reviews for A1.
I don't.
The Yelp reviews.
No, look, this is me. This is me. This is real shit. I've been in a relationship for 5 years, so where I'm at right now, I'm only 24. So I was 19. I have, you know, history, but for real, when you young and you doing your thing, I do work and I get up and I leave, or you get up and you leave. I don't ever think. If I really can't recall it, I don't really think that I've ever sat around to listen to any reviews. And once the person that I cared about reviews, it's been 5 years.
Yeah, you're a good guy. You know.
So
makes sense.
That's what matters.
Kobe and Lakers shit, like.
You know, Kobe didn't care about. He was winning rings with Shaq, but you know, he
I won more rings, like
you know. Two more rings without Shaq. You know, he didn't sit around and.
I ain't score 81 points with Shaq. You know.
Right. So I'm scoring 81.
Okay. All right, Mamba. Do y'all allow men to run red lights?
No. That's so gross to
they
me.
Just said yes.
Ew,
they just said yes to the face. They just said yes to the face. Take that shot and talk about it.
I just drank. I don't even know what you're talking about.
Do you let niggas run red lights?
Unknowingly.
See, for me, all right, while she's digesting.
Digesting
her drink. I would say for me is like, when that time comes around, I don't want to talk to nobody. I don't want to be around nobody. I like to be around myself, eat Netflix,
drink
ice cream.
Watch Netflix
and eat ice cream and just like chill by my lonesome. Like I don't want to be around nobody.
I respect that.
But other people, I mean, if those are people like Daisy,
talk about this. Come on, give your testimony.
All right, I'm gonna say it.
Hope my mom not listening.
She is.
I
told her listen. I got her number.
She loves you. Right? Cause she loves you. I don't know why. But anyway,
we know why.
If it's like I know it's about to come on, and if it's like the first day, and it's not really heavy on the first day, so it's like okay, let's do this before it like gets out of control.
So only on the first day? Don't you tell me?
Yeah, the first or the last day.
Never in the middle.
It's never in the middle because you don't want to be touched or like anything.
I don't like that shit because you know I'm very OCD type shit in a lot of ways. But I've been legit raped by women. Cause you know, y'all be super horny during the time or whatever.
More.
And I don't like this shit. Like, girl, really, like, we are established, y'all selfish. So niggas like, you know, I don't be the nigga be like, no. But that's how I be feeling. I don't want no parts. I'm sorry, I can wait a few days, but you know, y'all don't like hearing no.
Wait, but like, if I can't, like, there's other things that I can do. Like, you don't have to go inside me and witness all of that.
It's
you know. So I feel like there's other things that we can do for.
You said you got raped.
I have like a lot of times.
For me to release all that.
I don't like it. Like I don't like doing.
Pent up raped. Stuff inside me.
I like it. You run red lights now. You like a savage.
He does.
No.
It's not a lie. It's okay.
No, I'm not.
You run red lights, man.
Yes, it's okay.
Run red, like, that's something you don't do knowingly, and that's something that I hope that I...
No, some niggas do it knowingly. They like, oh, it's that time? I don't give a fuck. I'm right up in there.
Lay down that towel.
You're a nasty dude.
But it's like, when people say run red lights, it's like you gotta do stuff before you run the red lights. And you just can't run red lights when you've been outside all day. Like, you actually gotta go, like, get in the shower.
Like, you can mess, like, I don't know. It's like... Like she said, like you, like a woman know their body.
Yeah.
Like a woman know their body.
That's why
like,
it's always, I've always known because girls like they're like, yeah, you know, it is what it is.
It ain't.
And I don't care. I'd be like, but wait a minute, then it'd be too late. Like,
Yeah, I was about to say, like, a woman know their body, so you know on the first day, you know how that cycle go. But if it's coming towards the end and the woman might not know, then...
It's like, I don't care what day it is. I just don't want to be around people.
Shout out to Kelly.
I don't like people when I'm...
Sometimes you don't have a choice. What if somebody is around you? Because you just sound like savage. If I'm around you and I want it, I'm going to take it.
During these 4 days, nigga, don't delete my number.
I was talking to him. It was hard because it was like, okay, we sleep together every day. Then it was like, okay.
Yeah, this is...
I want it.
I'm actually like, cause I'm not like a typical dude. I'm not like a sex craze nigga. Pussy don't run me, whatever. So I'll be perfectly fine. I always have my girl on a cycle. Like I'm good. I know some niggas be like, damn, I gotta beat my dick now for the next couple days. I'll be fine. Like it's not that deep.
You will be fine.
Yeah. Like,
I'm about to say my came from like a woman knows their body. It's not like something that you intend to do. You don't just wake up one day and you just like, oh, you on your period? All right, still come over. I'm gonna die.
Niggas are like that.
No, niggas are like that.
Yo, I've heard some girls say they let niggas eat them. I don't know.
Nah,
I've heard it.
That's just nasty.
You ever heard of the ID channel?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where you end up.
What's the ID channel?
Where people,
like the killer shows.
We have a lot. Like, I know some people they don't like spaghetti because they feel like.
Shit.
From the books and stuff, you know.
I tasted like spaghetti like 2 days ago when I was like stirring. I was like, wow, why are we always talking mac and cheese? Like, spaghetti is like real shit. Like, you know.
Menstrual inside the spaghetti is supposed to like make the guy fall in love with you. So,
I didn't know you was even going there with it.
That's what I was going. That's why I said I know a lot of people that don't like, well, a lot of guys that don't like spaghetti.
What the fuck?
What was it? The coldest winter ever?
That's that Kensington shit, Daisy. Like,
it wasn't like the coldest winter ever. One of those like,
tell my girl
like
about that book.
That's that Kensington shit. You
put them. I read it and it was like I was cracking up because his nail is like when the guys be like, I don't want that, and they be like, why? And they be like, you should know why. Like,
it's a cold winter. We got to move on.
Right.
It's a
cold winter.
Next topic.
I'm disturbed. What do y'all think about manscaping? Do men need to manscape?
Yeah, at least just a little. Like you know how. Men can grow out a lot.
Of course.
Like, so I feel like there should be a little trim.
So let's say you get with a guy, real cool, good vibe, everything good. Y'all get down to it, probably a big ass dick, but you know, it's just like a forest though. Big.
He gotta cut it down.
But you still gonna suck it though?
He gotta cut it down.
Okay. So it don't really matter then?
It does.
So it don't really matter.
It's preference.
That's like how y'all say, like, y'all don't want the hair in your mouth.
Actually, me. I will be turned the fuck up. It could be a bad ass. Well, if it's like a super bad girl.
If
she got a forest down there, I might take the L today. But if it's like a regular girl's
for women,
a forest, I might be like, you gotta chew me out right now.
On some real shit, I feel like it's different for men and for women.
It is.
But it's a preferential thing. But yeah. For women, it's a pride thing.
Yeah. Like,
because for women, it's a pride thing. Because different parts of the world, you know, if you study European culture, and you study stuff like that, and you study even go to prehistoric times. Mm-hmm. That was a symbol of something. To be able to have, like for a man to be able to have a certain sized bush, that was a symbol of something. Mm-hmm. But for a woman, that was also in prehistory times of Europe. That was all like they would naturally grow out.
Would you say earlier though? It's 2016, so I don't give a fuck what the fuck they did in prehistoric times. Bitch, cut that shit down.
You wanna talk about
right now? Ain't shit going down.
If you wanna talk about right now, you should be on.
Yeah, that's what she is. She got a fucking forest down there.
Like I said.
Would you still hit
like
them?
Like I said.
He would.
If it's a super bad girl, I would. But she's a regular nice girl.
I'm gonna go to my
house. I don't think no girl should ever
like a force?
Like,
it's a problem.
That's gonna turn me off. Like real shit will turn me off. Like hair, I do not fuck with hair.
Yeah, and I feel like that's it. For girls, that's like
it's
a
legit gonna be in my mouth too.
I don't like it on the chest either, so it's like I don't
taco meat. I'm on some real shit. I hope I never get that shit.
I get a little hair in it, but it's not taco meat.
Are you 21 though?
Grown-ass
man.
Okay.
Why she disrespecting you like that?
I mean, nowadays, I'm not going to take it as disrespect. I'm going to take it as, am I savage?
Yeah.
21, 21.
That was my humbling stage.
But, Taco Meat, no, I don't want that. As a man though, you go take your shirt off and shit. You got nap. Like Taco Meat ain't nothing straight. You can't comb that, get that shit braided. That's nappy.
My dad has Taco Meat. He blunted it and he still get girls.
That's like that savage Jamaican shit though. He's savage.
It's a pride, all right, but ladies, you can agree that's a pride thing, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I feel like it's
actually want to be cleaned up. And,
I'd rather be as soft as a baby's bottom as possible.
I've heard women try to say, no, niggas who care about hair too much, that's because that's that pedophile culture. You want a girl to look like a baby. I'm like, bitch, what? Like, I feel like I want hair in my mouth? What type of dumbass shit?
Even for myself, like, it's just like,
see, but you don't have
hot. I don't want all that hair.
That's true.
Talk about it.
Like, girls sweat down there. Yeah. It's a real thing.
But then they try to say, well, it protects the area from.
I mean, it does. You can leave like a little bit.
Right.
But I do not have the whole like.
Yo, that shit. It's like that's like top five turn off of me. Like some hair down there. Like, everybody got standards.
It can be a preferential thing, but I think for women, it's a pride thing. For men. Yeah. For men, you can go a little while without a shape up.
Yeah, of course.
Because when you're young, when you're a young boy, you look like, damn, I want some hair on these nuts. Mm-hmm. And then when you get older, like older can be years. You just letting that joint rock out, and then you might be like, damn, all the niggas in. You know what I'm saying? When you watching your ex videos, like, damn, everybody.
Just shave it like low.
Right,
because
on the front of a woman, if we decide to take a little lick, you know, on the balls, right. We don't want no hair on our mouths either.
I remember the first time a girl told me that, though, and I took offense. I'm like, bitch, who the fuck you think you are to make me shave myself? Bitch, who is you? And I'm like, wait, she offering to suck my dick. Exactly. Why would I take offense to that? Like, let me shave everything. Like, but
it's preferential and it's pride. Who doesn't like to be clean? At the end of the day, to me, it's just being clean.
Right.
It's like a vacuum cleaner. Mm-hmm. You can vacuum the floor a whole bunch of times, and but after a while, you gotta empty that shit out.
Drop them gems, man.
You empty it out. Drop so as gems. As a man, you can do any scrubbing, washing that you want, but as a man, you also want to clean that shit up. Clean the shit up is a mutual thing. If a woman is down there, if she don't like fucking hair on, if she don't like hair on herself, what makes you think that she gonna want hair all on you, all in her mouth?
Exactly the same way y'all feel.
Is cheating a deal breaker? Always.
I believe so. I don't think I could ever like it that I'm not.
You mean like if we're just starting dating? Or is it like if we're been together?
No, yeah, in a relationship. Like, I feel like at least 2 years, just say. No, let's just say at least a year.
A year? Yes.
Let's get a clear definition on what cheating is.
He or she fucks somebody else.
Yeah, that's 100% cheating.
I don't think I can deal with it. Because I feel like it's like everything that you do. Like, oh, you didn't text me back. What were you doing? So
it would just be trickle down effect of more drama.
Just be 25 to life.
Right.
okay, so let's say y'all married.
We can work on it.
Daysha?
It'll take a lot, but we can work on it.
It depends on like who it is.
He fucked a random bitch in like Puerto Rico. What? Experience there or something? Like,
it wasn't, but it was like, okay, I can deal with it. Because it's like, who I don't cares? Have to deal with the like,
random mommy.
The girl.
Yeah, she never going to hear about it.
So you basically you just saying you don't want him to fuck girls that he like.
Hey, you know.
Yeah, I mean, like, no, it's just like, if I have to see this person or like even hear about her from somewhere else.
Or you know her from like, somewhere before.
Yeah, or one of my friends know her. It's just like,
you take it as disrespect versus
get him every day and
beat
her up.
And I feel that disrespect factor because I always feel that, you know, me being a man, I understand cheating from a man perspective. We are way more sexually driven than women are typically.
Okay.
So I understand the temptation about it. But I don't respect men who have real girlfriends who ride or die for them, treat them good, all that great shit, whatever. And they disrespect them. Meaning by having like bitches in the open, calling a girlfriend, like, oh, that just reckless shit, just messy shit, and just like that's disrespecting the girl because she didn't do nothing to you, and you're just embarrassing her. But if you gonna cheat, you selfish in that moment. All right, whatever. I'm not gonna judge you because I understand. And don't be embarrassing your girl. Like, that's just.
I seen something on Instagram and was like, my girl went out with a guy, and he was like, yo, bro, you've been cheating on her for the whole 2 years, like, and I was cracking up because it was like. You really mad because like she went out with somebody, but you've been cheating on her for the whole 2 years. Like, And that's how guys, I don't want to say niggas, but like that's how guys be.
Niggas. I was about to say, no, no, on some real, best friend. On some real nigga shit, niggas. Mm-hmm. That's a
yeah, I feel like there's a big difference between guys and niggas. Like,
here we go.
Let's not even say.
Here we go.
Matter of fact, I'm a professional, but at the end of the day, mm-hmm. every culture can be a nigga.
Of course. Yeah. Everybody
can exactly.
be a nigga. Or, you know what I like to say? Nagger.
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 Yeah. You ain't got to be black to be a nigga.
At all. At all.
You can do some nigga shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because, like, any color. Women try to fall into that myth of, oh my God, he cheated on me, so he don't love me. No, sweetheart. He still can love you. He still can appreciate you more than anybody in the world. But he just selfish, as many people are in different ways. Men just tend to be selfish in involving our dicks. Because our dick controls us a lot of times. It's not our fault. Blame God. But that don't mean he don't love you. But if he's out here disrespecting you, blatantly embarrassing, having babies on you, giving you STDs, all that wild shit that be on, like, Tyler Perry movies.
Or Mari,
then he don't love you. Like, right. Because, like, that's just putting you through unnecessary stress. I don't fucking like, understand that shit. Like, I don't get it. In a lighter matter, though, why do women have messy cars?
My car is
your actually, car is not messy.
Exactly.
But I've come across, I've heard.
My cousins that are my roommate, yeah. her car is the messiest of messiest.
But women tend to be cleaner than men, but your car is tend
it's,
to be
it's
dirty
just like there. Getting dressed. I feel like, you know how when we get dressed, everything is everywhere. When we're in a car, we gotta do our makeup, we can switch into clothes. If you have kids,
I feel like every person, like, I just had a conversation about this with my other male friend, and he was like, wise. And I'm like, oh, she got kids. Like, so.
How many kids?
It was two.
Bitch, so, she just dirty.
It was two. It was like they were young. So it was like, but, like, if somebody is single and don't have kids, like, their car is usually clean.
You think your car would be dirty?
My car would be clean.
Okay.
I'm crazy.
Yeah,
I feel like a car is such a small place that it can't be but so dirty or so clean.
No, girls be having shoes in the bag.
I've seen a lot of messy cars.
That's
girls be having dirty cars. I don't get it, because I know men are typically dirty, like, for some reason. I
just feel like that's too small of a space that you would notice that they're like...
They be seeing it. They be like, oh, move something away.
No, I want some real shit. Like, I walk into my room some days, I be like, God damn, like, it's time to do laundry. But that's a big space. You know what I'm saying? I can change, you know what I'm saying? Go outside. Nowadays, 112 degrees. I go outside, I get sweaty, I come in, I'm changing. Mm-hmm. I'm throwing that shit on the floor. I ain't got time to be what I'm
I feel like your rooms and, like, the cars is, like, different.
Yeah, that's way different. Like, a car, though, like, you know what I'm saying? You eat something, you can... clearly just throw that out. Like, what? Yeah. It's only, but so you can't change your clothes in the car. You can't, like, for a woman, yeah, they might have, like, they might wear a pair of sandals to drive and then put on a pair of heels once they get out the car, but you ain't gonna keep the same pair of sandals.
I don't understand it, but it'd be happening.
Switching them out.
Yeah, the trunk is what it, like.
The trunk can be crazy because you're gonna have some shit.
I feel like for a woman, it's gonna be crazy because it's gonna have, like, work stuff. Yeah, weekend stuff. Mm. And
why the fuck get weekend stuff in there on Tuesday and Wednesday?
Going
to their nigga house, so they
right,
had the weekend.
You gotta have like an overnight.
I'm talking about
bed.
Like a weekend, like an overnight bed. Oh, all right.
Yeah, that's your overnight bed.
But then it be open and still there.
No, I got OCD. I'm sorry, but it's like your weekend bag. Then it's like your work stuff, like files, or depending on what you work with.
Mm-hmm. I work McDonald's.
French fries
in the bag.
Trying to get your rat skills down on the
French fries on the floor. It's okay. Mm-hmm. But, like, where people sit at is, I feel like it should be clean.
Do y'all keep paintings in your purse?
I don't.
It depends.
On what? Where you going?
Yeah.
Is it a dick appointment type shit? Like?
No.
I hope you're not taking them to the club.
It depends on what I'm saying in the club.
I'm about to say, I've never heard of it. What did you get this from?
I've heard that from people.
It just like, depends on like where you're going, like how long you're going to be there. Like, you never know. Your period might come on and somebody might have access.
That's the only time I would wear.
I'm about to say, I've heard this.
Like, that's like a good excuse.
I don't care.
Come on, something, but you. I hope you're not just like, yeah, I'm having a cookout today. Let me throw these.
Oh, no.
It's going to be popping.
It's going to be popping. This shit today.
I feel like for as a girl, like...
Girls be having everything in their bags. Like.
I don't carry big bags, so, like, I don't have that type of stuff. But, like, if I did, I would carry that in my purse because you never know what may happen. Like, I always tell people, like, you can never have too much panties because you never know. Like, I can go, like, half a year without doing laundry.
Oh.
And because I have so much underwear, but, like, if something happens, if we go out power for half a year, I'll be cool.
Girl, definitely be having draws forever. Like, yo, pause. How many draws do you think you have? Rough number.
Rough number of draws, probably about like a good close to a month's worth.
So like 30.
Yeah, about that.
Like, I would say I have less than a month. I probably have like a good 20.
Yeah, 25.
Yeah, yeah.
Only because.
Good 20, 25, some shit. I don't know. Maybe.
And then also I have like certain type, depending on what I'm.
Special draws.
Yeah, no, like no, like
Versace draws. Freak-ass
nigga. I ain't getting no money. I like to, like, no, it's like, depending on what I'm doing type shit. Like, if I'm going to go play ball, I'm not going to put my low draws on. I might just throw on my Ethicas. If I'm going to go, you know what I'm saying? You might take a shower at night. I'm going to throw the hands on.
I would think you would throw your hands on for ball.
Nah, I mean, Ethicas, they feel good on my skin.
Oh, okay.
What you mean? You want something that's going to, you can move around and bend. But, like, if you take a shower, you might just throw the hands on after the shower. You're going to go lay down, go to sleep. So, like, it's also, like, categorized stuff.
I've been hearing a lot of, you know, I feel like a lot, like, the new culture is not wearing a bra. Like, they had a nipple print show and shit like that. I'd be seeing girls even saying, like, what's a bra? I got, like, 5 bras. And I'd be like, but it's 7 days at least. Like, can you at least have 7,
you
I think?
Can repeat. Yeah, you should at least have 7.
I just think it's a strong number to have at least 7.
But like, you can repeat bras. It's not like...
Like in a row?
Like, you can wear one on Monday and wear it on Tuesday.
Oh, I was unaware of
it. You can probably repeat... You probably can, like, not for a female. For a female, I feel as though y'all gotta frequently probably change underwear. But for a male, you probably, if I'm sitting in the crib all day playing 2K, I'm going to go to sleep that night in the same drawers, wake up in the morning. If I'm going to play 2K again, I'll probably sit there.
Oh, hell yeah. If I ain't going to work for 3 days,
I'm not going to run through my 30.
I ain't taking no shower.
See, that's crazy. Because if I'm home for 3 days, I'm showering every single day.
I'm going to shower. I'm not going to run through my 30-day supply. It's called laundry for me.
See, I'm not going to shower and not change the drawers, though.
That
seems to defeat the purpose.
Exactly.
If you showered that day, you clean, you sit there, you play 2K all day.
And they put the same drawers on? I would feel comfortable doing that. Like,
I feel like if I'm in the house, I won't wear them.
Whatever?
Yes.
I feel like if I'm in the house, I will wear like the little shorts. Mm-hmm. I won't put them on.
And that's another thing,
so
too.
So shit is chalk.
And actually,
I
only, like, if I'm going out, it's okay.
So you don't wear drawers at all? Gotcha. Okay. Moving on.
And bro, like, you want to know what's crazy about that? Some shit that I just said, niggas going to be out there, this nigga dirty. Nigga, you sat in the crib.
Well, no, they might call us both dirty for different reasons. Because you saying you shower, you at least shower, put on the same drawers. I'm saying I don't even shower.
That's on something. I'm so not like, going to wear.
If I'm not leaving the house, I'm not taking a shower. Two days.
You have to work 30.
No. You have to make a distinction of it. If you know that you're dry, like if I'm not going to go sit in 100-degree weather, sweating in some drawers, know that they're dirty, take a shower and put them back on. I'm saying if you get clean,
you didn't do nothing.
You put on a fresh pair, I'm sitting in the air conditioner playing a game all day, I'm not going to go...
Don't get the AC.
Yeah, you got to be in the AC, you got to be clean, you got to be dry.
You see balls in front of the AC or
not? Ooh, that's the best feeling ever. Like,
wait, you do that, bro?
I've done it a good amount of time.
Well, you just put your balls on the...
Now I'm in the vent. But, like, I don't feel like, you know...
The air immediately...
Yeah, you just lay right there in the bed. My AC right in front of my bed. I just lay there. You know, I'm watching TV. I ain't feel like putting drawers on yet.
That's
I'm
a
just like,
substantial thing.
So that's what girls feel like when they're wearing dresses. Like, so, you know, this is a nice feeling. Like, just breezy.
Icicles.
It's a very refreshing feeling. Like, it make you a peace of mind.
Balls in the fucking
AC. Peace of mind. But the AC gotta be on already. You can't just turn it on. It gotta be on full blast. And you're like, damn, like,
I feel like when I'm
frosty.
We have central air. My mom always have it like on -20.
Shout out to her. I know people have full, what you say?
Central air.
Ooh, brain lapse. We have central air, but don't keep it on. My dad don't keep the central air on. I'll be ready to fight this nigga whenever I'm in this house.
If it's like warmer outside,
it gotta be 130 degrees for my dad to keep the central air on.
Oh no,
he lives in Chicago, right?
Yeah. Like it gotta be, he gotta be about to drop dead. He's like, all right, we turn it on this. Shyrack sandwiches, like, man, I'm good for it.
She has it on.
They've
been through enough heat.
Shyrack is at least, I mean, the heat is at least in his worries.
And he a cop.
Right.
That's at least his worries. Heat. What's that? What do you think about prenups? If your fiance's like, yeah, babe, no.
It depends. If I'm the one with the money or he's the one with the money. Or we both got money.
You see how women are.
If I'm the one.
You see how women are. Versus
he. My nigga, you see how women are.
What does that mean?
Not like either one.
What you say?
I would do prenup.
Give me up top.
She lying.
I would do a prenup.
Shut up. You already said it.
No, listen. Let me say my explanation. I would do a prenup because if he's the one with the money. While we're married, I would bring up some type of business or something that I'm going to make money off while we're married.
That mm-hmm. he has to invest in.
That I mean, he has to invest
I don't,
in.
I don't blame nobody for that because you still got to make your own money even if I invest in it. So.
Exactly.
Continue.
So if something happens and we were to split, I'm going to get some type of money regardless.
But if you had the money.
I have a kid about you.
But if you had, continue, but you said you had the money though.
I mean, if I had the money and he didn't,
I ain't
investing in
your
business either.
But I don't get why a woman take offense to that though.
I don't know. Maybe it's trust. It's like a trust thing. It's like, yeah. So you don't trust me.
No, it's like, yo, I have car insurance. I have house insurance.
Get upset about it.
They like, oh, so you planning for the future? No, I'm planning for. You planning for our breakup?
I was about to say, I don't see why.
I feel like
that's a big sign of like not logical. Like you're not a logical person.
If you want to be a housewife or like just
no, I'm cool. My husband's not for.
Shut up.
I have nothing against housewives.
She's a liar.
I'll be a housewife and still have a little business. I have
no sympathy for women who choose to be housewives. And let's say they break up, and they'd be like, "Oh, but what about my lifestyle, bitch? You chose to be a part of my lifestyle and not do shit besides being part of my lifestyle. Now this lifestyle is over." Kick rocks. Like,
well, it depends. If you got a kid, that lifestyle ain't really over.
But they be expecting to have child support and alimony.
I mean,
and then once I can get it,
the system not set up.
But she don't deserve to get alimony. What the fuck I'm paying you to break up with you for?
The system not set up for. Because
you wanted to break up with me. Like, I break
you with a good hair.
With you.
Oh,
Jesus.
Like,
B said it.
For Becky with the good hair.
Yeah.
B is with hoe. What did she say? Like, what are y'all talking about?
No.
Oh.
Because.
Oh, I didn't hear the rest of the album. I just heard don't hurt yourself. I turned off the album after that. That's all I heard.
I ain't sorry.
Don't play yourself.
Yeah.
No. Oh, man.
I might have to work with this Beyonce character one day. I'm like, I can't come.
Record record show that.
That's his Velcro for his ACL injury.
I had to look
bald like.
Yeah.
Allegedly.
But,
him and Q.
I'm out here still.
Becky with the good, I want to just, we ain't going to spend too long. I know we got topics and stuff that we got to touch on. But the Becky with the good hair thing,
Let's talk about it.
No, we're not going to eat up the show talking about Becky with the good hair.
Let's talk about
so what you going to say?
That?
Are you ready?
I'm glad.
Y'all look just like a meme. Yeah. We ready.
We ready. She put the wrist and shit up.
We ready.
Like, you gotta
talk about
when
it.
Becky? When a girl hit the wrist on this angle right here, you see the fingers and the angle and shit.
Beware. Beware. Right. Beware.
But the Becky with the good hair thing, that fucked me up because it was like, you more so said that, first of all, anybody can be any type of name. Anybody can be any name. But Brittany can be black or white. A Becky can be black or white, but
well,
you just.
Becky's a white.
But you.
There's some black Rebeccas out there.
But that's exactly.
We don't call him Becky.
It doesn't matter. That's your preference because what you do is you categorize, and this is where this whole racism thing comes in, and people categorize. So if I said a person was named Carlton, you would assume that Carlton was white. That's because
you saw Carlton Banks was white.
Right.
Yeah.
Who was that?
Carlton Banks is white.
Who was black?
Barely. Super barely.
But you know what I'm saying, you know, it's certain names that you would establish with certain things. Okay. So if you say Becky with the good hair, why couldn't that be a black woman with a good hair?
Because we all know Becky is a white person name.
No, you all assume that Becky is a white person name.
But I feel like what Becky
most stereotypes are
so
true.
So what you basically saying by agreeing with Beyonce is that black women can't have good hair?
No, black women can have
Becky.
Becky, she didn't say
her. So we just have to assume that Becky was white.
Yes.
I feel like Becky is a term for a white woman, right?
Yeah.
That's what they used to call Becky.
Or a term of at least mixed descent, at least.
Yeah.
What back do you know that is black?
Do you know any black Beckys?
I don't know anybody named Becky at all.
I know three Beckys and they all white.
Shout out to Becky.
I don't know. I mean, the Beckys are cool. They were just white.
Yeah, hey, nothing against Beckys, but you're most likely white. It's okay though.
I mean, all right. You know what? I'm gonna be rational. That's just like saying Jamal.
Most likely, it is what it is.
Yeah, most likely Jamal is black.
Yeah,
I guess
people get so uptight by stereotypes, but at the end of the day, most stereotypes are true.
Yeah, you can't be mad at it.
You can't say Becky with the good hair though.
She said Becky with the good hair. She didn't say with the girl hair. The girl with the good hair.
What if she would have said Becky with the bad hair? Well, that would have
you would have probably thought that would have been a plot twist.
Becky.
I would be like, that's confusing, B.
Like, white woman. She would have used like a ghetto name, like Shaniqua.
Yeah, it, you know, she wrote it for a reason. It was a point to the message.
My friend, Shaniqua.
I mean, at the end of the day, like my man said,
if your name's Shaniqua, most likely you ghetto. It's okay though. Like, it's
cool. Lemonade is still a popular drink. Let's move on, Q. What you got next for us, man?
But
no, I ain't trying to hear this.
Right.
If a guy asked for a prenup, what would you say? Y'all never say actually what you would say. Yeah, you would say.
I would say yeah
because I feel like I would be really successful.
I mean, if I say no, you're just not gonna get married, so I'm not gonna take that loss. So I'd rather take the win.
I feel like
she don't want to take the L.
To be honest.
So I don't know, some girl might be like, you better marry me anyway, type shit though. Like,
nah.
I feel like Lex is will be like on her own.
Yeah, I'm gonna make money regardless. So like, yeah. If I get that prenup, I'm gonna find some type of way.
Like if she
gonna
get a prenup and she's like, and that's 90 million, and she be like, this nigga ain't getting my money. So hold up.
And end of the day too, that's what I'm glad you said that. End of the day, I don't give a fuck what type of prenup a nigga has. The girl still gonna end up with money. Cause y'all be taking money every which way. Y'all always find a way to, or like my mom should always tell me.
I'm pointing.
Shout out to Kirk, bro. We need a sponsor. But my mom's always told me, like,
he said we need a sponsor.
Yeah. My step pop, as most men, they can't remember bills for some reason. Like, they can't remember to pay bills or this and that, whatever. So my mom, she would pay the bills and this and that. And he would have to give rid of. Huh? I mean, because y'all always think about something.
Okay,
so y'all
continue.
I digress. So he would have to give rid of money back, whatever. So in her mind, since she's a conniving woman, as y'all tend to be.
Why does she gotta be conniving?
Because y'all are conniving. So if she paid $500 for the bills, he would come back to her like a week or two later. Hey, so how much I owe you for the bills? You
know that's interest.
And she might be like, 800.
Interest because
what type of interest y'all on? Like,
she taking out her paycheck or her bank account.
We live together.
And then it's set 2 weeks later. But that's 2 weeks not her responsibility.
Right. We live together.
Is that her
reason?
We live together, but
like, I'm paying the bills still.
She got other stuff to look at.
What are you looking at?
Like that girl first goes that we had to pay for that she was just talking about earlier.
And she getting the money right back.
She took an L on her bag that was on sale at the moment to pay your bill.
My.
So now the bag is not on sale.
Your bill.
Her bundles that
she's that's where Elijah come out.
I'm about to say that shit go from you. That go from we to you.
You know what's worse? Was almost worse than a girl not having logic. She said, when they try to explain her logic, he'd be like, what?
The lack of logic.
What? What? That's how you justify it?
Jesus.
She said. Damn. Shout out to the crowd.
She said, your bill. Yeah.
Yeah. That was your responsibility.
Our heat, our heat, our water.
I had the phone.
Our mortgage.
Oh, yeah. You had one job.
I would never let the bills go. Like, it's how people be like, oh, my shit about to get cut off.
I would never have to get that for it.
But that's not solely your responsibility.
Yes.
It's not. I feel like if a guy's continue to play that and he be like, oh, I don't have it this month, okay.
It's not about having it. It's just like, damn, I'm irresponsible.
I feel like I'm irresponsible.
Yeah, I can relate. I'm not like that. But
it's the 22nd. Whatever, like, 23rd.
We got all the iPhones. There's reminders.
Like, my shit is automatic. Like, my bill, I don't got time to be thinking about shit. Just take shit.
I was about to say, I like to just set up.
It's 2016. I don't have time.
Nah, because
if I had to date and be like, oh, this is the one this day, it's just like, oh, it's dropped. I have to, like,
what's today's date?
I'll 15.
Bill coming up. Okay. I got shout out to Bank of America. I got
$5.
What's something, like, you know, you with a guy for like a year or two, like, y'all in deep, you know, a girl, whatever. What certain things are just off limits? Like, what are y'all boundaries?
As far as what?
Anything.
I feel like
some things that's turn you off, boundaries that you not cool with.
Years?
Y'all like a year or two in. Like, y'all in.
Like, it's a big difference between a year or two.
2 years in.
All right, for me, one bad thing, and I might sound like a horrible person for this, but like one thing I really don't like is a guy crying. Like, keep your tears
to yourself. Suck that shit up, nigga.
Keep your tears to yourself. Like,
you better, man. I respect that. Okay.
Cry in your closet or something. Like, don't cry in front of me. Like,
what if his mom dies?
I don't like that.
Yeah, what if, okay, well, if well, what's the degree, though? Can you cry about anything or nothing? My mom died.
If your mom died, you can put that there. Cold-hearted.
Cry about that.
Damn, cold-hearted. You know, I'm not a crier. But you tell me my mom died. You it's putting limitations on my tears.
You can cry. I just really hope you don't cry in front of me.
Damn.
I'm sorry.
I cried in front of a girl one time in my life, and that's because somebody died. That was because somebody died. I knew, and that was like just a few teardrop, and that was that. But I definitely wasn't just like. But if I was, bitch, you better.
I don't know how.
You don't gotta touch me. Just sit there. Like, I don't need comforting, but you know.
All right, that's all I can do is comfort you.
No, don't comfort me. I don't need comforting.
That's all I know how to do is comfort. So.
No, just don't talk to me.
I feel like that's the most awkward thing ever. Like, how do you comfort someone in that situation?
That's crying.
You ever cry from a girl, Mo?
I never sat there and be like, but it's been times like you have tears come down your eyes. Like
your mom's dying.
Some people experience real shit. I had a, like me and my girl had a mutual friend, like her best friend. Mm-hmm. We had a mutual friend. I wear her every day on my wrist. Rest in peace, Steph. But I wear her every day on my wrist.
The one time I cried when she cried, that's when I cried.
Right.
Girl,
yeah. That was times where, it's certain times when shit happens, but mm-hmm. I never sat there and, for real, I don't, it might sound weird, but for me, I don't know, crying is like a hard thing to do. I don't know.
I'm not a crier by any means, like.
It's not even about being comfortable, like, shit just happened, and it's like, it's weird, it's hard to cry.
I cry literally, like, all the time.
I cry all the time.
But I don't cry in front of people. I cry in my, like, little space, nobody knows I cry.
I feel selfish when people just cry in front of people.
I think it's like that. It's like, I don't know. I think, like, crying is, like, a skill. I don't know. It's like,
I feel like it's just FAB or something. I'm going to snap out, so that's why I usually just cry.
Because, like, I get upset. Like, I've been upset in front of a woman, you know what I'm saying? You get upset, you might
talk about it,
feel a certain type of way, but like, even when as upset as I was about a whole lot of stuff that happened, I don't think that I've actually sat there and been like, crying for real. Like, you might get like one tear out of me, and then that might be like, all right, wipe that jaw.
Because somebody died important.
Yeah, like somebody important, like death close. That's an excuse.
But just like,
but you probably stuff. Still only gonna get one tear out of me.
The Denzel tear.
I feel like little stuff is just like, we're girls.
Yeah. You don't get to sleep.
Because when I'm really sensitive, it's just like, oh yeah,
I fucking hate that shit.
Stop talking to me, leave me alone.
Kind of like, why are you crying?
It's just because you like worked up.
That's why are you crying?
I feel like it's like worked up.
And then I hate when y'all be like, oh, you don't care about my tears? No.
I feel like if I'm
cause
like,
it's not
so
serious. Cause it's not serious.
As of right now, it's like,
y'all know, y'all look back at certain times and you're cry, like, it really wasn't
like,
me.
If it's not, a serious situation, like, crying would be funny as hell.
Yeah, it's like, yo, I don't like, take you seriously. Just because I'm crying, don't mean I'm going to take you seriously.
I'm that person to laugh.
Goddamn laugh. I would.
But when it's me, it's just like, I will punch you in the face. Don't laugh at me.
Like, I'm not going to laugh. I'm going to be mad. Like, why the fuck are you crying right now?
Like if you just came and like, yo, man, like, I just lost 500, and then you're like, you're crying.
I gotta laugh at you.
I'm gonna laugh.
Cracking the hell.
They be waiting for me to have any type of weakness in life. They want to make fun of me so bad.
I'm waiting.
Like,
yeah, I'm waiting to, man. Waiting. People are so insensitive.
Yes.
With everything. I'm sorry.
Life isn't that deep.
I mean, that's how you are, and that's cool.
Life isn't that serious. It really isn't. Most things in life isn't that deep.
To you.
Damn, that's why me and this dude can't beef. I meant to.
Cool. But I it just like really ain't that shape, deep, like,
because they just hate
it. It just
like,
really
so
ain't that deep.
We have to, like, I feel like that's big. Like,
yes, I
it's
love
just
it.
Not, yo, like.
Y'all not as genuine as us.
We are.
Hello. We've been friends since
I feel like longer than
it don't matter. Did you fly her out?
Janelle.
After 2 months?
Talk about it.
Did you fly her out after 2 months?
Fly
out.
I feel like
don't say it like that, though.
No.
Fly it out. Hold on.
I bought my own ticket to you, Mel.
No, yeah.
I bought my own ticket.
Did y'all become close on your French, your trip to Florida, was it?
That's when we got close, yeah.
That's when you
got close. Oh, okay. We've been close forever.
There were other men.
Was it
2016?
Miles.
I don't think you know.
Yeah, Miles and Darren was
fine. When we had did you go to school with him?
I worked with him.
Okay.
There's another weird 6-degree separation. Whatever though. But
but shit is real. Like, but if I saw that nigga crying down in Florida, I would laugh.
I would laugh at Alexa too. I'm sorry. If it was like a death or something.
Speaking to the mic,
I'm sorry.
She also would have like punched the person in the face.
I would. I'm sorry. I'm that best friend.
The more violent person, I'm the more.
Daysha more violent than anybody. Like.
Yeah. I'm really an angel.
She's from Kensington.
I'm not from Winfield, West Philly. Sorry.
Don't niggas move away from New Jersey, New Zealand.
You just won't let that die.
When niggas move to Jersey, but I'm from Jersey.
You just won't let that die.
You've never been a part of.
Like, right. Why you always in?
He won't let that
die.
I have a good memory. So I like to put things in perspective.
One time for somebody.
That was not one time.
It was one time for somebody used to talk.
I feel like you would never went to Kensington more than once.
I feel like it was not one time. He lived in Germantown.
I know exactly where it was at.
Germantown is right there.
I didn't know they were so close.
I know exactly where it was at. I still drive past it for other reasons. I tried dating here like 5 times.
All right, you getting personal?
It's not 5 times. Though.
What are you going to Kensington for?
We went to Westchester. I feel like that was the only time McHugh dropped me off.
Moving on.
What you got for us, too?
Now it's time to close out the show with some other random questions. 24 hours to live, what would you do? Each of you.
I feel like I would have to travel the world.
You have 24 hours to live.
You're going to travel the world.
I'm going to travel the world. I want to go to Africa.
Tomorrow, you have 24 hours to live.
I'm about to say, it takes fucking 18 hours to get to Africa.
You have African money, Daysha.
I feel like if I'm going to die, somebody's going to get me there.
Somebody get me there.
Somebody's going to get me there. I would just spend time with my people.
You too?
Yeah.
Mine?
Octane Mel coming up, 24 hours?
24 hours to live. Like, 24 hours to live.
24 hours, sir.
I'm going... I'm trying to be professional. I'm a career.
Octane Mel.
No need to be professional.
It's RightonQuelive. We're not professional.
This is like professional. But anyway, 24 hours to live. Like, this is if I, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to smoke a mad hell of a lot of weed. I'm going to turn. Uh-huh. I'm going to drink all crazy. I'm going to party with my niggas. I'm going to spend money. I'll probably catch a body.
All right.
Is the body your girlfriend?
Don't say that out loud.
Hey, no evidence. Well, he won't die anyway, so...
No, I'm not talking about, like, fuck somebody. I'm like, I'm...
You want to kill somebody. Why would you want to kill somebody?
Everybody got somebody they want to kill.
Yeah, it's probably somebody... somebody that owe me money or something.
That's Trump.
Yeah, right. I'm at least
making an attempt. To a Trump rally, like, okay. You know
that. I'm at least making an attempt. Shit.
At the 23-hour, go to a Trump rally. You know?
But, like, 24 hours, though, like... Real shit, 24 hours, though, I don't know, like... That's some shit that you can't really ask, because, like... Yeah. I can say that I would do a whole bunch of stuff. Mm-hmm. The only thing guaranteed that I would do is probably get turned up. And then I'd just go after that.
In my 24 hours.
24 hours is crazy.
I would bring all my family and close friends to Jamaica.
Oh.
You got money like that?
24 hours. I'm going to find some type of way to get some money.
How we got money, though?
Talk about it. Talk about it. You didn't ask about money. You just said talk about it.
You're a walking lip.
Talk about it next.
So we're all going to Jamaica. We're going to turn up what you seen bold. Mm-hmm. And Wops Cartel will come out of jail. We're going to turn up with him. Right. We're all going to get lit as fuck. Shop online and get everything we want.
Well, fuck, 24 hours, I'm gonna go party with Wayne.
I'm gonna have one lit night.
I'm fucking everything on my list. That's like 30 people long.
We're gonna have one lit night. I'm gonna
turn the six upside down. It's a nod now. Like, be realistic. Like,
anything's possible.
I'm gonna do some real shit. I'm gonna cop my regular.
Anything's possible.
I'm gonna go get this quarter.
Listen, I'm gonna spend a whole night savings. I'm gonna spend every single dime I have.
How much she got saved? Damn, who is she?
I'm gonna run off on the plug twice. I'm gonna go to Del Frisco's, order everything on the menu, run out of the John. I'm gonna go to Rumor.
That's not even that Rumor.
I'm gonna go to Real Hurt. Then I'm gonna go to Vanity. I ain't gonna throw no money. I'm gonna do illegal stuff. Yeah. Like, I'm trying to be realistic.
I'm gonna steal
like,
a
I'm gonna go right. I'm gonna steal a car. Right. I'm gonna go.
Why?
Because I'm gonna die anyway. By the time they get me in a holding cell, it's too late. All I got 30 minutes to live.
I'm gonna die a legend.
Oh my god, if I die.
You wanna know what's bad about that? What? People that's remember forever? Who the niggas you gonna remember forever? Columbine?
Alright.
9/11
people.
No, that's real rap though.
If she wants to steal a cop
car,
she can steal a cop car.
But then you also have like
you're not gonna be a legend.
What
you gonna do with 24 hours?
I'm gonna make sure she's a legend.
So why are you not solidifying your legendary living right now? Why you gotta wait till it's with your last
name? I am.
No, but
she
why?
You her way to get your Jamaica shit.
Within my means.
But your means, if you feel as though within 24 hours you can secure yourself being a legend, then you should live every day like this. And within these 24 hours, I can.
If she do that Jamaican trip, she would have nothing to work
exactly.
For.
Exactly. You gotta be realistic at the end of the day. If I do everything
today. I'm being realistic. I'm going to smoke this
corn. I'm gonna be in tomorrow about it.
Yeah, like, that question got real deep.
That 24 hours.
Yeah, man.
All right, moving on. Never wrote a book, what would it be called? Anybody?
No.
I read books, nigga? Like,
nah, man.
I mean, I don't read, but.
I see, like, poetry and stuff, but it's just like, you know how you get, like, the title, it just never matched, like, what you're writing about?
It can be about your life or about anything. A book.
Oh, a book? I got a book.
Title. I would never know the title
Long
until it's, like,
Lex.
No. I like
respectful.
It.
I don't know.
You gotta come up with a title.
Okay, well, it's called Daisy. Moving on.
What was yours?
No one's been about it.
Nigga,
yeah.
I'm gonna be
yours.
Nigga, what's yours?
Oh, my book probably be called "It Is What It Is."
Okay. If y'all can revisit any time period in y'all life to give advice, what would it be?
I think before I went to college.
To not be
to be given or get. I mean, to be given
to
or
give
to
yourself
give.
Advice. Yeah.
To give myself advice. It's college. I feel like I should have taken it more serious. I learned a lot in college.
I would go back to when I was 5.
Okay.
Because on some real shit, a little bit of explanation, not going to take too much time, but mm-hmm. explanation about that is a lot of things that you do, a lot of people that grow up, they don't really know it, that if we grow up all of our lives trying to do so many things at one time that we don't realize that if you're going to go back and give yourself advice, then by that time you already know what you want to do. And it takes, is a book that I read, I think it's 10,000 hours. If you put 10,000 mm-hmm. hours into anything, then you can become a master of it. So I would have told my 5-year-old self that, take this advice.
Start right now.
Yeah, 10,000, you can have 10,000 plus hours that you can put into this. So I would have told myself that.
I definitely would have been rich by 16.
Yeah, but. Anything right. that you wanted to do. is people that go to Harvard at the age of 14, 15, because they invested that 10,000 hours. So I would have told myself at 5 years old.
I feel like if our parents would have told us that, then like, I feel like we all know.
I feel like I would tell myself right now to just find one thing that you love doing and to work hard and to continue.
Oh, when would you have told yourself that?
I would tell myself right now.
Right now?
Yeah. I feel like in college, I had the best time of my life. The 4 years being in college, like, I literally had the best time of my life. Like, I enjoyed it. I had fun. I learned from everything I did. 5 years old, I don't remember much. But
You was carefree in college, right?
Yeah, I was pretty much carefree.
How about if you handle that responsibility when you're 5 and you can be carefree for the rest of your life?
Yeah, but I wouldn't have all the experiences that I have now. Like, I feel like I lived in college. I did whatever I wanted to do when I wanted to do it. Like,
but if I
and I still passed.
Some ducats.
And I still passed. Yeah, and I still I got a degree. So, well, like, what? Right now, or graduating, I would say graduating college. I would say to figure out, well, if it was... whatever I did figure out, what I didn't figure out, I would figure out what I want to do, go for my dreams, and live it. Like, I would spend every time as possible working on my future self, on what I want to do.
Respectful.
What would, if you could visit any time period in history, what would it be? And if you could have dinner with anybody dead or alive, what would it be?
We got like 1 minute, so let's
yeah.
go.
Yeah.
Time period you would visit and dinner with one person.
Can this be the future?
Anybody, yeah.
I would visit the future Just so that I could see, like, where I am.
Okay.
And I could see where I need to be and what I need to be doing. And I would have dinner or whatever with someone that really, really, really likes to eat that didn't get any weight, so that I could see, like, how they continue on in that life. Because I like to eat, and I don't want to gain any weight, so I'd rather be with somebody that, like the Asians, you know, they eat a lot. And
she said the Asians.
40 seconds.
The Asians. I would probably do the future also, just to see where I am. But I also would like somebody in Flint, Georgia. Like, to see where I can do better at. Like,
I would...
Time period of who you want
time
to be.
Time period
with.
I would visit. I would visit. I'm gonna go to the dinner first. I would have dinner with. Not yay. I'll probably have dinner with a young Bill Gates.
Okay.
And the person I would visit my future self at my peak health. Peak health being like in my latter years, but right before, you know, you can come down with a sickness or you're gonna mm-hmm. die eventually.
Okay.
Just to see where I'm at, where my mindset is at.
Well, gotta end it.
Unfortunately.
Thank you guys for coming.
It was real.
Kelly, Daysha, who just left. Mel, would y'all come back?
Of course!
I'll be back.
All right, thank you. That was Ryan Q live. The men won. Bet with a second. We definitely won.
No, we didn't.
Shout out to us.
Shout out
to Team Mel. We got it. Hey, Ryan Q live.
Yeah.